In this video, we're going to talk about what it means to be the greatest common factor. So let's first note that 24 can be written as 2 multiplied by 12. 16 can be written as 2 multiplied by 8. So the fact that I've written 24 as 2 times something, and I've written 16 as 2 times something, what that tells me is that both 24 and 16 have a 2 in common as a factor. So the 2 is what we call a common factor. So the way I like to think about it, it's as if the 24 and the 16 could, you know, pretend they could talk to each other, and the 24 says, oh, I have a factor of 2, and the 16 says, oh, I have a factor of 2 as well. And they would say, hey, we have a factor in common. The 2 is a factor that they have in common. On the other hand, the 24 can also be written as, well, 3 times 8. And the 16 we can still leave as 2 times 8. And now once again, if the 24 and the 16 were talking to each other, they would say, hey, we have an 8 as a common factor, right? But notice that there's no larger number that they have in common as a factor, right? That is, 8 is the largest number that goes evenly into both 24 and 16. So 8 is not just any old common factor. 8 is the greatest common factor. So the greatest common factor, that would be 8. Okay, so not only is it a common factor, it's the largest common factor, or the greatest, if you will. Now, the greatest common factor is often abbreviated with the letters G, C, F. So if somebody asks you to find the GCF, they're asking you to find the greatest common factor. Okay, so now consider the following two expressions. Consider 16x to the third and 20x squared. And let's say that you were thinking about the greatest common factor of these two expressions. Now once again, imagine that these expressions could talk to each other. And first they could focus on their coefficients. And then, you know, the 16, well, when they were speaking to each other, this one would say, oh, I have a factor of 4. And the 20 would say, I have a factor of 4 as well. And that is the numerical part of our greatest common factor, because there's no larger number that goes into both 16 and 20. 4 is the largest part, is the largest number that goes into both 16 and 20. So the GCF, that is the greatest common factor, is for sure going to have a 4 in it. There's no larger number. On the other hand, there's more going on here, because we have x to the third and x squared. And if they were speaking to each other and asking, you know, hey, you know, what do we have in common? This one would say, I have 3x's, right? X multiplied by x multiplied by x. And this one would say, I have 2x's, x times x. And then they'd say, what do we have in common? Well, just like you and a friend, if you were talking to a friend and wondering what you and your friend had in common, and you discover that you both liked going to the beach, that's something that you would have in common. You both enjoyed going to the beach. Likewise, this one has 3x's and this one has 2x's, and they say, oh, we both have 2x's in common. I can see that you have more than 2x's, but at least we have two x's in common. So the GCF is not just 4, they also have 2x's in common. Okay? And that's why the GCF of these two expressions is 4x squared. It's the most that they have in common. Okay, let's try another one like that. Let's find the GCF. So find the GCF of, how about something kind of complicated? Let's go 24x squared y cubed. And how about 36 x cubed y. So once again, a nice way of thinking about this is, imagine that these two number or these two expressions were conversing with each other, and they'd start with the numerical parts, right? They're coefficients. Do you see the largest number that goes into both 24 and 36? Well, 2 goes into both of those numbers, and so does 4, and so does 6, but there's a larger number. That larger number would be 12. So the GCF is going to for sure have a 12 in it, because 12 goes into both of those numbers. They have this as a factor in common. Now, what about the variable parts? What about the this part and that part? And again, if they were comparing what they had, this one would say, I have 2x's as factors, and this one would say, I have 3x's. What do they have in common? Well, they both have 2x's. And then likewise, they're comparing how many y's they have, and this one says, I have 3y's, and this one says, I have 1y. How many do they have in common? Well, they both have 1y. So the GCF of these two expressions is 12x squared y. It's the greatest common factor of these two expressions. Okay, so what we'll do in the next video is we'll use the GCF as a way of factoring an expression. So factoring is going to have, we're going to have many techniques for it, and we often start with a GCF when we're working with a, you know, anytime we have a problem and there's a lot going on, there might be multiple techniques that apply, and we always like to start with the GCF when factoring. And we'll do that in the next video.